Is it clear? Okay, clear. Thanks for giving me the chance to represent myself and my company, Regenerative Medical Services Private Limited. Our company is mainly into stem cell banking and into stem cell treatment. Right? The company mainly, I am the assistant medical advisor with the company. Our company is India's first company to introduce cell therapies. Cell therapy means the stem cell treatment therapy. It may be from the stem cells or it may be from the bone marrow cells. Right? The treatment and presently what we are giving is autologous chondrocyte implantation, that is the cartilage implantation, the autologous bone implantation, that is the bone defect implantation into the body, and the third unit is the umbilical cord blood banking storage, because as we know, the future and the potential of umbilical cord blood banking is rising day by day. The cord blood and the cord tissue banking, that is the hematopoietic stem cell banking, and the cord tissue, the mesenchymal stem cell banking. Now, basically, I will make you understand what stem cells are. The stem cells are the master cells of the body, which has a capacity to regenerate and which has a capacity to differentiate into many cell types of the body in future. There's a sentence written here, the ability of a stem cells to self-renew and give rise to subsequent generations that can differentiate offer a large potential to culture the tissues. Basically, what happens when our body goes weak or we are diseased? The cells, the tissues pathologically deprives. But this cells, stem cells have the capacity to replenish and regenerate those damaged part to the body. If you continue with this thing, potentially to culture tissues that can replace diseased and damaged tissues in the body without the risk of rejection and side effect. Right? Any queries you can ask me? Yeah, sure.
The difficulty is to understand.
Yes. Skin cell, yes.
But you say the skin cell, if it is there in the liver, it will develop.
It can generate into liver cells.
There in the heart, it will develop into the
heart. Yes, heart cells, yes. See, this is a kind of a process, because at presently the stem cells are the blind cells of the body, which are the major cells which are developing the baby into the mother's, or we say into the bone marrow also. Into the adult bone marrow, recently the cases of blood cancers which are being treated with these things, the blood related dyscrasia which are being treated. So this is a process. Once your cells are implanted into the body physiology takes the action that way. Once you implant into the heart, the damaged heart, the cells which are generated the heart, and once the heart is damaged, the research says that, and the process which has been studied till now indicates on the medical report, that after implanting the stem cells into a damaged heart in conditions of CCF, in conditions of MI, where the stem cells have been injected and the records are there, where it has been shown that the future and the treatment has been good on the ground, and the ejection fractions of the heart has also been increased. In cases of diabetes also, means the exact mechanism of the process, it's a very detailed understanding of the mechanism, how does it goes. That once the cells are implanted via IV into the body, then how it goes and how it reacts.
That part I have to get it.
Yes.
You implant the stem cell. But what is it that makes this stem cell to take up the structure or the functions of the heart?
There is the physiology. Yeah, see, where it is placed, it goes to like how our, this what we say, the hormones act into the body. They are released from the thyroid gland and they go and act on the remote places. Same with the stem cells have the ability inbuilt in them, that they have the ability to replicate into the cells and differentiate. Once they go into the body, they find the damaged target organ and then they replicate and they differentiate and they make the organ back healthy that way. Now, the what are stem cells? Basic cells of the life characterized by the ability to renew and differentiate into a diverse range of specialized cell types. This is the main answer. That way, right? The stem cells extracted from the umbilical cord and cord blood possess an ability to save the entire family from many hematological, immunological and metabolic disorders in future. Right? The sources of stem cells are many, but the best source nowadays many people are banking for is the umbilical cord blood banking and the umbilical cord and placental banking. Right? Types of stem cells. At here you guys will little bit understand that how many type of stem cells are. See, stem cell is a basic cell of the body which has made each and every part of our human. Even the hair, the skin, each and every part, the base is the stem cell of the body. Now, there are different types, that how the differentiation takes place. The base are four types, that is totipotency of the cell, pluripotency of the cell, multipotency and the unipotency of the cells. If you see in the totipotency, potential to generate embryo and placenta, the initial type of stem cells. Right? Example, the zygote. Second thing, coming to the pluripotency, capable of differentiating into almost any cell of the body slash embryo. That are embryonic stem cells, little bit higher stage of the stem cells. Multipotency. They are essentially committed to produce specific cell types. Example, hematopoietic stem cells of the body, means the blood cells. And the fourth one, unipotent stem cells, the skin stem cells. In the example itself, it mentions. So these are the major four types of the stem cells. Again, in the four types, there are many differentiation below downline. But as if I go into deep of this thing, then I will require more than two and a half hours to explain each and every type of stem cells, what it is. This is basically a placenta, because see, the stem cells, we get it from many sources. As I told prior, into the cord blood, into the cord tissue, the human bone marrow thing. Many, and the slide itself showed that what are the sources of stem cells. Right? But the best is the placenta, transfer section of the umbilical cord, that is the baby. Right? Now what is cord blood, basically? A cord blood? Pardon? Sure. Yes, yes, you can.
Just would like to know.
Yeah.
Is there a morphologically differentiation between the stem cells and the other cells?
Means how? Morphologically difference between the stem cells and the?
Other cells.
Means into the...
There is a stem cell in the bone marrow.
Yeah.
Bone marrow has all the cells of the...
All the cells of the... Not all the cells of the bone marrow.
How do you distinguish that this is the stem cell?
This is the stem cells. Because see, in bone marrow, basically we get are the mesenchymal stem cells. The MSCs, what we say, major cells of the body, mesenchymal stem cells. The differentiation of the MSCs are the main part. Means once you collect marrow, the same cells, see, you might be seeing here, mesenchymal stem cells of the body, MSCs. They are the muscle cells, the embryonic, the mesoderm layer of the body. The mesenchymal stem cells of the body, main. So that is, in bone marrow, you get MSCs. Same MSCs, you get it in the cord tissue, that is. So the morphology.
These are the bone cells, and these are not the stem cells. Bone marrow has so many types.
Bone marrow has got many hematopoietic, mesenchymal stem cells. According to the morphological structure under microscope, you can differentiate them. Yes, that is them.
This is the stem cell, and this is not the stem cell.
Not the stem cells. No, that.
How can you separate them?
Right. No, that differentiation, once we see under the microscope structures, at that point of time, 100% we can differentiate, and we can erase the part which is not a kind of a stem cell, 100%. That is how we remove the major cells of the body. When we do a bone marrow transplant, we remove the unwasted part of the cells, and we only keep the MSCs, and we use it for the treatment. That's a biotechnological process which is run. And under microscope, we come to know the differentiation that this is a blood stem cells or this is a mesenchymal stem cells. Yes. The variety are so-and-so. The cord blood is routinely discarded after birth, but a process known as cord blood banking allows families to save this valuable resource for potential future medical uses. See, at presently, stem cells is an evolving science in India, because it has been only 5 to 6 years that the concept itself has came to India. So every day a new research and a new medical trials are going on in this concept. Now, how does cord blood relate to stem cell research? This is, I think, so it will answer your query. So the Cord Blood Donor Foundation states that the cord blood is an excellent source of stem cells. Mean the cord blood, right? Cord blood stem cells can be used to treat leukemia and other cancers in the same way that bone marrow is used, with a much less chance of rejection. Because our bone marrow has got many good things also and many bad things also, like the mutation defects of our body are there in bone marrow. But if you use the cells, see, it clearly mentions the cord blood can be used with much less chances of rejection into the body. Later on, it will more explain that what are the rejections that way. So what's the stem cells? Stem cells are especially in that they have the ability to develop into many different types of the cells within the body. The National Institute of Health claims that they are the repair features of our body. Once they are implanted into the body, they go to the defective organ and make their work over there. It sounds like a little bit, okay, it looks like a movie. That is something which is not possible. No, but there are research papers what we have treated the cartilage defects, bone defects. I will be showing later in the slides where you can get a confidence on that things. Now coming to the hematopoietic stem cells, that are the HSCs mainly, the blood stem cells, right? See, basically there are proerythroblastic phase, monoblastic phase, myeloblastic phase, lymphoblastic phase, and megakaryocyte. The transformation process goes into the body. in the final outcome goes to the main, the first five, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, that are erythrocytes, monocytes, neutrophil, basophil and eosinophil, the WBC cells of our human body. The second, the lymph cells and the platelet cells of the body. These are the main structure of the blood stem cells. The blood hematopoietic stem cells. Right. Any questions on this slide? Okay. Now coming to the cord tissue. See, the cord tissue, it has got two veins, one arteries. The main source of mesenchymal stem cells is the Wharton jelly, which is inside the cord tissue. And minimum hematopoietic stem cells, as you asked me prior, that how you can differentiate. Okay, in blood the concentration of hematopoietic stem cells is much. In tissue, it is minimum as compared to the concentrated part of the blood. Now the process, mesangenic process, that how mesenchymal stem cells are differentiated. The mesenchymal stem cells goes into proliferation, then the commitment phase, the lineage progression, differentiation and the maturation. At the end, the important thing you see is the bone, the cartilage, muscle, marrow, tendon and the ligaments, which has been transformed from the osteogenic phase, chondrogenic phase, myogenic, marrow stroma and tendogenesis phase. Later on, this process goes multiplication of the cells and they are differentiated into the final fine-tuned features, that are the bone cells of our body, cartilage cells of the body, the muscle cells, marrow cells and the tendon or the ligaments of human body. Any questions on that slide? Clear. Now the umbilical artery, there are two arteries, one vein basically. Now are cord blood stem cells different than other stem cells? Yes. When compared to adult stem cells, cord blood stem cells are biologically unique and are advantageous due to the higher rate of proliferation. That is, this blood cells can be proliferated, can be multiplied with a good amount. Immunologically, immaturity, that they are not 100% mature, that how we want, it can work in our body. And reduced exposure to virus and aging. In comparison to embryonic stem cells, cord blood cells are proven safe in human body and have been used effectively for decades in medical treatment. Any questions? It's fine. See, about 9 lakhs cord blood units have been stored privately for personal use and about 100 autologous transplants have been performed worldwide. 20 years ago, due to low cell dose, means, see, everything here depends on the cell dose and the cell count, that how much cells are proliferative, cells are multiplication capacity of the cells, as compared to other sources, means from the bone marrow, from other sources, the peripheral stem cells, the more amount of proliferative capacity of the cells is much more good. And in future, the treatment with the cells will result into much more faster recovery and lesser amount of graft versus host disease. That is the rejection ratio, what happens in